Clayton Kershaw, Andy, you're on the clock now.
Yeah, this is, like, Gary's just a jerk. Gary is just a flat-out jerk. He got me again. That's three picks in a row. I was looking at Trinan. Love him. Love the park. I'm going to come back with Mike Clevinger. He's one of the few guys on the board where I think we can say comfortably that he's going to get close to 200 innings. There's just not a lot of that in today's major leagues. We've talked about it already. Only 13 guys pitched 200 innings last year. Only 23 guys reached 190. And I feel really good about that, the floor for Clevinger. You guys have also mentioned the division. It's just should be a cakewalk for Cleveland. He's in a situation where he's just going to pile up wins.
Andy, you have done to Dan Gottfried what Gary has done to you. Dan just said in the chat, dang, wanted Clevinger.
So, I was going to take him too.
What goes around comes around.
Well, what a value in round six. I think he's got round three stats and he's got round one hair.
In the all-hair league, number one.
I do not have round one hair.
So would everyone here at this desk take Clevinger over Kershaw? Off the board. Andy, you're back on the clock.
Finally, Gary didn't absolutely burn me there. I'm going to take David Robertson. Kimbrel was the guy that I was hoping for, right? You guys
hit number 16.
Oh, can I just say I was fully triggered by the Domingo Santana pick. That is who I was eyeing here. That's a guy who's just like a year removed from a huge power speed season. I see no one really blocking him in Seattle. He's like, I think he's just a great pull this late. That was an awesome pick. I also like Stripling, who just went ahead of me. Gary took him, sniped me again. I am going to go Marcus Semien here. A guy who, like, is a pretty clear 15-15 candidate with the possibility of a 2020 season. We've seen him already hit as many as 27 homers in a single season. The batting average probably not going to be there, but middle infielder with power and speed, sign me up.
All right, so, Marcus Semien is off the board. Another Oakland A, part of the Oakland A's offense, is off the board. Austin Meadows, outfielder for Tampa, off the board. Jay Happ, Yankee starting pitcher. Dylan Betances goes as well. Now, DJ, you're up. We're flying.
I'm going to go with you.
Those are some credentials right there.
Yeah.
So we have a shark.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't know that. Should have kicked him out. Gary Jackson, who has been taking Andy's picks right before Andy gets the chance to do it, will be in 10-plus leagues this year. I feel like that's on the high side. I don't think I can handle it.
Yeah, I think we've probably all done double-digit leagues before. It's a little overwhelming.
When people ask us how many leagues we're in, we usually don't have the number.
Yeah.
It's at 10-plus. So you're one of us, Gary. You're one of us.
You do for a living. Yeah. Mike Levin also. I think he might live out in the Bay Area. He's an Andy, are you in a box right now? You obviously are not claustrophobic. Are you?
I'm kind of sort of in a box right now. I just want to underscore the fact that Gary is the absolute worst. I'm disgusted by Gary. He has been a constant annoyance in this thing, and I can't wait to have it over. Good riddance to Gary.
Respond in the chat. You are free to respond in the chat to that. Who do we got next here? We got Orlando Mendoza.